Hey guys, it's Chris. From the sheep that terrorized a French village to the woman who had her hands ripped off by her own monkey, here are 10 wild cases of when animal taming went horribly, horribly wrong. Number 10. Trampled to death by sheep. Some animals just can't be tamed. Animals are insanely unpredictable, even the ones that don't look all that intimidating. This includes an infamous sheep that has been terrorizing and bullying French villagers south of Bordeaux for years before finally trampling to death a pensioner inside of an isolated footpath. You might think, yeah, okay, but it's just a sheep. It should be fairly easy to push it away with your knees, right? Well, this sheep was absolutely relentless. Police were recently called in to investigate the death of a 94-year-old man who'd been taken down by this infamous sheep. But it wasn't the first time this crazy sheep was caught trying to murder someone. It was famous in the area for attacking people on their bikes, for chasing people up telephone poles, and for sneaking up behind ladies and headbutting them in the hips, trying to bowl them over. People tried to fight off the sheep the best way they could, but to no avail. And finally, one day, the sheep just went too far. The old man was found with wounds all across his face and body. Witnesses reported seeing the violent and untamable sheep lurking nearby after the incident. Sounds creepy? It's believed that the sheep charged the man, knocked him down to the ground, and then punched and kicked him to death with its hooves. One local resident was quoted saying, "The sheep was a well-known troublemaker." Some believed it was just a matter of time before this aggressive sheep killed somebody. And unfortunately for the sheep, a spokesman for the police confirmed that it has since been captured and put down. Number 9. Angry lion. A zookeeper recently ran into a bit of trouble one day at the Shoalhaven Zoo in New South Wales. 35-year-old Jen Brown is a certifiable lion tamer, so literally her entire job is to be a zookeeper, and she's supposed to look after and care for the lions. And even if they can't be properly tamed because they are still wild animals, you'd think that the zookeeper and the animals would at least have a friendly relationship. Instead, when Jen walked into their enclosure to do some cleanup, they pounced on her, ripping open her head and neck. The vicious attack required Jen to undergo an emergency blood transfusion. All the blood was almost completely drained from her body. The lions were only 18 months old at the time it happened, so they were still relatively small and young. But they must have been pretty hungry. Maybe they were just curious cubs doing curious cub things like kids who get into trouble. But since the incident, they've shown no additional signs of aggression and will not be put down. No one blames these young lions for their mistakes, and Jen is expected to make a full recovery. Number 8. Snake King versus Cobra. It takes some serious guts to be a cobra tamer, and not really a job people are just lining up outside of job fairs trying to get. But there is one man from Malaysia named Ali Khan Samsudin who calls himself the King of the Snakes. And he had quite the reputation for being a fearless and invincible cobra tamer. That was, until one of his snakes bit him and he died. But he had a pretty good go of it. It's Malaysia's most famous snake charmer. Ali had put on amazing shows where he kissed deadly cobras on the lips and completed other amazing feats of bravery almost every day. According to ABC News, he suffered his first bite at only 21 years old. And it would only be the first of many. He worked with other deadly animals too, even completing stunts like staying with 5,000 scorpions in a glass case for 3 weeks. Living with a group of over 400 snakes for 40 days. So why did he do any of this? Well, we're not really sure. And alas, it would be a bite from a king cobra on an ordinary Tuesday afternoon that would be the death of him. He died in a Kuala Lumpur hospital at the age of 48. Oh, and this happened just a few months after the tragedy of Steve Irwin being killed by a stingray. What do you think about these people that play dangerous games with animals and end up suffering the consequences? Please let me know in the comments below, and if you're liking this video, be sure to hit that thumbs up and the subscribe button too. Number 7. Elephant chase. Just because you're at a wildlife park doesn't mean the wildlife is tame. A few tourists learned this the hard way when they became the victims of an angry elephant attack while on safari in India. The tourists were in a jeep checking out the local elephants, and they were thinking the giant creatures were pretty friendly. But this was before one of the bigger elephants turned and started chasing down the jeep. The massive elephant seemed pretty determined to attack the people inside of it. They only escaped from the rampaging monster by the hair on their heads. Then, in the middle of the chase, the elephant lost interest, made a sharp turn, and started munching on some nearby bushes. Apparently, his attention span isn't as great as his memory. In the end, the tourists were all okay and they learned a very valuable lesson. Everything in the wild is unpredictable, mostly untamable, a little bit dangerous, and sometimes very, very moody. Number 6. Ripped apart by a monkey. Chimpanzees share quite a bit of DNA with us humans. A lot of people believe that they're basically our distant relatives. But just because chimpanzees look a lot like people doesn't mean they can be tamed like people. Can people actually be tamed? Well, we'll leave that for you to decide. Charla Nash figured this out the hard way, though, when her friend's pet chimpanzee literally ripped off her face. The chimpanzee belonged to Sandra Harold, who thought she had done a pretty good job of training the chimp to be friendly and sociable. After all, she'd raised Travis, her chimp, from a baby. He was usually very good with people and often traveled around the town with Sandra and her husband Jerome. One of their neighbors even said Travis listened better than her own nephews. So it really wasn't that big a deal when the chimp started playing with her friend Charla. But then out of nowhere, the brutal chimpanzee turned into a wild monster and began to claw at Charla, eventually ripping off her face and her hands. Her eyes and lips were torn off, and all the bones in the middle of her face were crushed. Her injuries were so ghoulish that she will never look the same again. She now has to wear a veil over her face because the chimp ripped all the skin off, turning a pretty normal face into something else entirely. In fact, her injuries were so severe and so disturbing that hospital staff who had to work to save Charla's life were offered counseling because of the trauma that they suffered. Charla has since undergone a face transplant and will be living in a care home for the rest of her life, all because of her friend's unpredictable chimpanzee. Number 5. Cheetah Keeper. At the Columbus Zoo, a zookeeper was attacked by an angry cheetah after taking the large cat out for her daily exercise. The cheetah's name is Isabel, and at the time, she was a fully grown adult at 4 years old. The zookeeper, whose name has not been published to keep their identity a secret, was used to spending time with Isabel and the other animals at the zoo. This wasn't her first rodeo. It also wasn't Isabel's, as she was described as an incredibly well-trained animal. She's been trained to cooperate with blood draws, ultrasounds, x-rays, and many other medical procedures in order to minimize the use of anesthesia. Isabel had her harness on and she was being led from the cheetah facility to the yard out of public view. When the zookeeper went to get near the cheetah to say hello, it pounced unexpectedly and mauled her. Experts at the zoo claimed it was the scent of other nearby animals that had caused the cheetah to lose her mind. No matter how familiar you are to the big cat, the scent of a giraffe can still throw all that training and taming right out the window. The zookeeper did make a full recovery, and the cheetah was given a brief timeout of 30 days before being returned to her enclosure. Number 4. Beekeeper killed by bees. Beekeeping isn't usually a dangerous hobby. I know everyone that's afraid of getting stung would probably beg to differ, but it's really not. Beekeepers don't exactly tame bees, but they do keep them, and that's almost the same thing. But 31-year-old April Taylor had been beekeeping for 2 years when her very own bees rebelled against her and stung her to death. It happened outside of her country home in Utah. Her husband found her after the incident, lying unconscious and covered in bee stings. According to the New York Daily News, April suffered somewhere between 30 and 40 stings, which overloaded her system with bee venom to the point where she died. Even if someone doesn't have an allergy, they can usually tolerate about 11 stings per pound of body weight. About 100 people are killed by bees every year in the United States. It's not clear exactly how 40 bee stings proved fatal, but it's likely April could have had an allergy and not even known about it. As for why the bees attacked, a bee expert was called in afterwards to inspect April's property. He found that the hive was missing its queen. And because there was no queen around, the bees were feeling especially protective, and when April got too close, they swarmed her, managing to sting the woman to death even with her suit on. Number 3. Untamed wolves. Taming wolves is definitely not an easy task, obviously. The Caswell County Exotic Animal Preserve animal trainer Haley Kay was in the wolf enclosure attempting to socialize two young wolves. Instead of hanging out and being friends with each other, the wolves turned on their trainer and attacked her in unison. They bit both of her arms and then started gnawing on her right leg. Others at the animal preserve had to rescue this poor shrieking woman from the savage beasts and take her to UNC Hospital's Hillsborough for immediate medical treatment. She was nursed back to health and made a speedy recovery. And she even told local news that she will definitely be going back to the animal park to continue her training with those two wolves. But what's really wild is that this is the same animal preserve in which another attack had happened 2 years prior, where an intern was mauled to death by a lion. These guys might want to reconsider their animal training program, just saying. Number 2. Bit by an orangutan. An employee was bitten by an orangutan at the Erie Zoo. It happened inside the zoo's main building, according to the CEO of the Erie Zoological Society. The victim was Mitchell, a 29-year-old zookeeper who had worked with many of the animals at the zoo in the past. He wasn't even doing anything with the orangutan. He had simply been walking through a corridor adjacent to the exhibit when the orangutan, a 28-year-old female named Dasa, reached through the bars, grabbed his arm, and sunk her teeth into his flesh, nearly ripping the guy's arm clean off. I don't know, maybe she just didn't like the way he smelled that day. Workers at the zoo said that ever since Dasa arrived in 2000, she's never shown any aggression or hostility. The zoo also said she was probably just being inquisitive, reaching out through her cage to see if she could grab something. Then maybe she wanted to take a little bite out of Mitchell's arm, though not in any kind of violent way, she was just curious. It was just a little bit of a love nibble, and that's kind of the thing about taming wild animals. Even if you train the orangutan to behave appropriately, she still might get curious and try to bite someone. And seeing how huge the teeth of an orangutan are, that bite can sometimes prove fatal. Though in Mitchell's case, he did make a full recovery. Number 1. Man's best murderer. There's nothing worse than when man's best friend turns against you. And yet in North Carolina, dog taming went horribly wrong when a young woman... And yet in North Carolina, dog taming went horribly wrong when a young girl, really no more than a baby, was killed by her two family dogs. This is truly a tragic and horrifying incident. According to Fox News, the father of the infant had stepped away for just a second. And in that brief window of opportunity, the two dogs attacked the baby, mauling her to death. The real horrifying part is that the dogs were usually protective of children. The family thought their dogs were tame. They hadn't had any previous issues and were not worried about them being near their child in the least. But worry or not, it turns out their pups were far from tame. And it probably didn't help that they were Rottweilers, notoriously aggressive dogs. They attacked the young girl. The father tried to help her, but she was dead by the time they reached the hospital. Now it's up to the family to decide whether they'll euthanize their killer dogs or let them live. Thanks for watching. Would you dare to tame one of these wild animals? Let me know in the comments and be sure to hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. We'll see you next time.